Hello everyone, in this video we will see the effect of the excitation on the power factor. Due to the change in excitation, we will see how can we control the power factor of the synchronous machine. We will also draw the phasor diagram to understand this. So let us take the case of generator first. In the previous video, I have derived the equivalent model as EF excess. In this discussion, we will assume that the resistance is negligible and this was given as terminal voltage. Okay, so now first let us take that the load is such that I connect the load here. This is IA. Load is such that the current is lagging VA, that is lagging load. That is IA lags VT by angle say theta. Okay, so let us take VT terminal voltage as the reference phasor. We are also given that IA lags VT by angle theta. Okay, now VT plus JIA excess gives EF from this equivalent network model. So I can write just taking some phasor which is perpendicular to it. This is 90 degree angle and its magnitude is equivalent to IA excess, then their addition will give me, sorry, making this like this, this will give me EF. So you see the magnitude of EF is more than VT. Now we also see that for generator, EF will always be leading the VT by some angle which is known as power angle or torque angle called delta. We will see that this delta angle is very important in power system stability studies also. So if I draw the phasor diagram which also shows the flux, then I will find that the lagging current creates an effect such that the armature reaction is opposing the rotor flux. Let us see how. First, you have seen that for lagging current, EF is greater than VT. Similarly, if the current is leading, let us say if the current is leading, this is for leading load now. Let us say current is leading by same angle theta. Okay. So I will take some phasor which is perpendicular to it. This is 90 degree. Okay, if I take some phasor whose magnitude is equal to IA excess, then this will give me EF. Now clearly from here I can see that EF magnitude is smaller than VT. So for leading load, excitation is smaller, but for lagging load, excitation is higher. This shows that for the lagging load, we need to input more rotor current so that it somehow balance is the demagnetizing effect of the armature reaction. That's why for lagging load we have to increase the rotor current so that EF is higher. No load voltage which will be induced just by the rotor flux is higher. But for capacitive current or for leading load, we require that the rotor flux or the rotor current is lower, that is excitation EMF is lower. Now let us draw a phasor diagram showing the demagnetizing and magnetizing effect of the lagging and leading current of the load in the next slide. Here in this phasor diagram, to clearly see the demagnetizing and magnetizing effect, I will take theta is equal to 90 degree. That is, first I will take the case where current lags by 90 degree. This is Vt, okay, and this will be Ia. Now what will be Jia excess? It will be in this direction. First let us draw the flux also. Now you see that Ia or flux, armature reaction flux due to armature current, will be in the same direction, and the armature MMF also will be in the same direction, which I already told in the previous videos also. And this will be, let us say, represented by this phasor. Now this is the resultant terminal voltage, okay, Vt. Now if I somehow get the value Ia excess, so Vt plus Jia excess, what it will give? It will give me EF. So if Ia is like this, what will be the value of Ia excess, which is leading this by 90 degree? Jia excess will be written in this direction, that is leading current by 90 degree. This is Ia and this will be Jia excess. So Jia excess, let us say, can be written as like this. This part is Ia excess. So this total will come out to be EF. Okay. Now we have already seen that the EMF lags the flux by 90 degree. So I can write that the flux which is due to rotor alone will be in this direction, that is leading EF by 90 degree. So let me make it little bit higher to express the magnitude. So this will be the initial rotor flux, but you see that the armature flux is completely opposite. So in this way we can see that for lagging current, this armature reaction flux is having a complete demagnetizing effect on the rotor flux. Similarly, for capacitive current, we will find that it is having magnetizing effect. This is demagnetizing effect. Let us see for the capacitive current. Let us see, this is Vt. Capacitive current will be like this, Ia or phi AR or FA. This is FF. Now what will be Jia excess? Jia excess will be in this direction. This is Ia excess. So this will be EF only. Now this is the direction of armature reaction flux and this is the direction of EF. What will be the direction of FF? Still again this direction. This will be direction of FF. So you see, phi f or ff and phi ar are in same direction. That is, this is having the magnetizing additive effect on the rotor flux. So in this way, we have seen that lagging load creates a demagnetizing effect and a leading load creates a magnetizing effect on this synchronous machine. Now let us see what is the effect on the power factor if I vary the excitation in the next slide. For this part, I will assume that the synchronous generator is connected to an infinite bus. What does it mean? An infinite bus means that the terminal voltage will be constant and the frequency will also be constant no matter how much input power is increased or the excitation is increased. Okay, so let us take, this is Vt. And we are also taking that the input power is same. That is, the power output is same. If input is same and if I neglect the lossy, then output will also be same. Then Vt Ia cos theta will be the output power of the generator. Since Vt is a constant, for power to be constant, Ia cos theta must remain constant. If this is P and if this is constant and this is constant, then Ia cos theta must be constant. So let us say initially Ia is given by this at some angle theta. So what will be cos theta? This will be Ia cos theta. So if I vary Ia along this line, if I vary the value of Ia along this line, let us say like this, this is Ia1 and let us say this is Ia2. Along this line, Ia cos theta value will be same. That is, the output power taken from the synchronous generator will be same as that of P, since Vt is already a constant due to infinite bus. Now first let us take a case of the lagging load. Now you see, this is a lagging load, this is Vt. So Vt plus Jia excess will give me, this is Jia excess, this is 90 degree, this is Ia excess. So this will give us the value of EF. Let me draw it little bit more clearly. So Vt plus Ia excess will give me this EF. Now this angle is taken as delta. Okay, if EF cos delta is equal to Vt, then we call it as normal excitation. If EF cos delta is greater than Vt, then it is called overexcited. If EF cos delta is smaller than Vt, we call it as underexcited. So from this diagram, we see that an overexcited synchronous generator delivers a lagging load, or it absorbs a leading current. That is, overexcited generator gives lagging current. But if I write it in this way that over excited generator, instead of giving gives, if I write absorbs, then I can write that it absorbs leading current. Now from circuit theory, we have seen that a leading current is absorbed by a capacitive load only. So in this way, I can see that an overexcited generator is acting like a capacitor. Similarly, if we take this case, the leading current, this is the leading current, let us say now we are taking the leading current, we will find out that the EF will be reduced. EF will be like somehow here. So I will see that EF is smaller than this, EF cos delta is smaller than VT. So this will be a case of under excitation. I will see that when the generator is giving a leading current, then it will be acting like an inductor. Okay, so an overexcited generator acts as a capacitor and under excited generator acts as inductor. Now let us take the case for the synchronous motor. Let us draw the diagram for synchronous motor. This is VT. Now let us say it is absorbing leading current. This is IA. This is theta, which is leading. That is, motor is absorbing leading current. Now we already know that VT is equal to EF plus JIA XS. Okay, or EF is equal to VT minus JIA XS. So what will be JIA XS? JIA XS will be in this direction. So what will be the negative? It will be like this. It negative will be in this direction. So if I add this, this is minus IA XS. This will give me an EF equal to this. So you see here EF cos delta is greater than VT. So here again, this is overexcited. This is overexcited case. So we see then that overexcited motor, synchronous motor, absorbs leading current. Now we have seen in circuit theory that a leading current is absorbed by a capacitor. So overexcited synchronous motor also acts as a capacitor. Similarly, if we make a phasor diagram for lagging current, let us say this is a current lagging, we will find out that the EF value will be reduced. This will be new EF for lagging current. This will be a case of under excitation. That is, if motor absorbs a lagging current, then it acts as underexcited motor. So you see that overexcited synchronous motor acts as capacitor, underexcited motor acts as inductor. We have seen that similar statement was made for generator also. If I change motor with generator, the same statement were made in the previous slide. So in general, I can write that overexcited synchronous machine, both motor and generator, act as capacitor and under excited synchronous machine acts as inductor. So instead of learning or remembering that we have to remember for motor and generator separately, I can just remember these two statements. Even though I do not require even to learn this also, if I know how to draw the phasor diagrams, but still it is easier for interview questions to remember just these two statements, that over excited synchronous machine, whether it is a generator or a motor, acts as a capacitor, and under excited synchronous machine acts as an inductor. Now in the next video we will start the new topic of the transformer and its equivalent circuit model. If you find that this video is helpful to you, then it is requested that you please share and subscribe our YouTube channel, and also press the bell icon so that you can get the notification of the new videos as and when they are uploaded. Then now such an action of subscribe and share also motivates us for uploading new videos. We have also created a Telegram group whose link is given in the description for doubt discussion.